Would you like to see the changes in your QuickBooks Online account when you activate the multi-currency feature? Well, this video will show you everything that happens in your file when you activate multi-currency. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. Before you can record transactions with more than one currency, you must activate the multi-currency feature in QuickBooks Online. This means opening the account settings window and clicking one box just to turn it on. But what will happen in the QuickBooks Online account after the multi-currency feature is activated? Well, here are the changes that you will see. First, you will notice that a new main menu choice is added to manage the multi-currency feature when you click in the cogwheel. And if you click the currency, you will see that you now have a new list called the multi-currency list, or rather currency list, that actually tells you the active currencies and allows you to add new currencies that you are now doing business with. You will also notice that there are a new set of two reports that have been added to your set of reports in QuickBooks Online after you activate the multi-currency feature. And of course, a new set of data fields are shown added to transaction windows to show the effects of the multi-currency feature. So let's take a look at how to add this in QuickBooks Online. So let's activate the multi-currency feature in your new account. When you click the cogwheel in the top right, you see that there is no currency choice here. But if you click Account and Settings and go to the left panel and click the Advanced category, then scroll down to where it says Currencies. Then click the pencil tool to be able to edit the section. Then when you click the box to activate the multi-currency feature, you have to click another box that asserts that you understand that in this QuickBooks Online account, once you activate the feature, you cannot turn it off, and all the changes to the accounts that we just discussed will be permanent in this account. Click Save. And now let's take a look at the results. Click Done and click okay. Let's see. If you click the cogwheel, you now see that you have a currency list as one of the list choices, and it has just been added to your QuickBooks Online account. If you double click, you can see that by default, we have the home currency as the US dollar, and we have only two out of several currencies activated, the most common and the most likely alternative currencies that an American would use. But of course, if we need to add more currencies, we can click right here. You will also notice that if you click Reports, Standard, and scroll down to Business Overview, two reports have been added to this account: Realized Exchange Gains and Losses and Unrealized Exchange Gains and Losses. These two reports were not here before we activated the currency or multi-currency in the account settings window. And the last change is if you click New and you open any transaction window, you will notice that there is now a column to declare what currency you are using for the transaction. So these are the changes to your QuickBooks Online account after activating the QuickBooks Online multi-currency feature.